Hello, Kampala Junior Academy. Good morning. How are you? This is Jonah doing the science. Topic, simple machines. Subtopic, police system or police. I know this is a new term to you, but you have ever seen police. Let me begin with the definition of a police. We say a pulley is a freely rotating wheel with a grooved rim. I'm going to explain. Let me first write the definition. A pulley is a freely rotating wheel with a grooved rim, or a pulley is a wheel. Which turns on an axle. A pulley is a freely rotating wheel with a grooved rim. When we draw a pulley system, a pulley has a part where it is fixed, then it has a part, it can be called the axle, then a rim, and now this one is a, when we say a pulley is a freely rotating wheel. This is a wheel that rotates around this fixed point. It has a pivot in the middle. Now we say a pulley is a freely rotating wheel with a grooved rim. Now when I talk about the grooved rim, this rim here is a grooved. It has a part which is a grooved. It's like a valley. The rim has a part which is like a valley. That part is said to be a grooved. Oh, we say a pulley is a wheel which turns on an axle. Now this one is a wheel, then this one becomes the axle. A wheel, this rim has this grooved part is where the rope passes to lift an object. I remember telling you that the object carried by a machine, or the things carried by a machine, are called load. Then the energy you apply on the machine is what we call effort. Now, when you come back to our pulley system, or a pulley, we say a pulley is a free rotating wheel. This is a rotating wheel with a grooved rim. This one is a rim. Then this part, which is like a valley on a rim, is the part we say to be a grooved. And the reason why it is a grooved, the grooved rim prevents the rope from sleeping off the way. If the rim is not aggrooved, this rope is going to slip off, or it will get off when you are lifting the load. Now, what's the use of this rope? It is the rope that pulls, the rope holds the load. This rope, it is the one that holds the load, and it has to pass on the aggrooved rim in order to lift any object. Now, when you look at the parts, this one here, the part where the wheel is attached or fixed, is called a block. It is like a handle. It's called a block. Then this one, it can be a chain. It can be a chain or a rope. You can either use a chain or a rope, depending on the object you are going to lift. Then this part here, this is the load. Then this part here, this is the pivot. I remember I talked about the turning part of a machine that is called a pivot or a fulcrum. This pulley can work as a lever, like it is where we shall talk about the types of pulleys, and we shall talk about a pulley system that works as first class of levers, and we shall talk about a pulley system that works as second class of lever. This is a block. Then this one here is the wheel. Then this one is the rim. Then this part here is the part which is aggrooved. This is a groove. The aggrooved part, a groove. This aggrooved part prevents the rope from slipping off. Then the rope is used to lift. The rope is used to hold the load. Then the pivot, that's the turning point. That's where the rim rotates from, or where the wheel rotates from, to simplify work. Those are the parts of a pulley system. Then we talk about the types of pulleys. We have three types of pulleys. Types of pulley system. I know you have ever seen that device, that simple machine. We shall see how they are used in our day-to-day life activities. Types of pulleys. One, we have a single movable. We begin with a single fixed. We have a single movable pulley. Then another one, we have a single fixed pulley. Then we have another one. It's called, when you combine a single, it is where we combine a single movable pulley and a single fixed pulley to get a block and tackle pulley. This block and tackle pulley is also called a fixed movable pulley. We shall talk more about that one. But these are the three types of pulleys. We have a single movable pulley, we have a single fixed pulley, and a block and tackle pulley. Then let me begin with a single fixed pulley. A single fixed pulley is a pulley is a wheel fixed on a block. We say this pulley, it is fixed on a block. Now, when you are using this pulley, the rope is the one that it turns on the wheel, but the wheel is fixed on the block. The work of the pulley is just to rotate. It rotates on a fixed point, and when it rotates, the rope moves, and when this rope moves, it lifts the load. This pulley works as first class of levers. It works like, it works as first class of levers. And the reason why it works as first class of levers is because the fulcrum or the pivot is between the load and the effort. That's why it works like a first class of levers. And this pulley system changes, it changes the direction of the effort. That's the advantage of using this single fixed pulley. It changes the direction of force. Instead of lifting an object directly from the ground, you are going to just pull downwards. That's an advantage. And it has one advantage. It has one mechanical advantage. It has mechanical advantage. It has mechanical advantage of one. Its mechanical advantage is one. We shall see why it has mechanical advantage of one. Now let me draw a single fixed pulley. I've said that single fixed pulley, the wheel or the rein is fixed on a block. Then it is the rope which passes on to lift the load. The pulley does not move with the load. The pulley just rotates, and when it rotates, this rope pulls the load. We say it is fixed on a block. It works as first class of levers, and the reason why it works as first class of levers is because the pivot or the fulcrum is between the load and the effort, and it changes the direction of the effort, or it changes the direction of force. This one means that instead of lifting an object directly from the ground or straight from the ground, You are going to pull a rope, and the moment you pull the rope, this rope is going to hold the load, and you see the load going up. That's why it has mechanical advantage of one, just pull downwards. It has mechanical advantage of one, and the load, the effort needed to overcome the load is supposed to be equal to the weight of the load. I say, the load, the effort needed to overcome the load on a single fixed pulley is supposed to be equal to the weight of the object or the weight of the load. Now I'm drawing a single fixed pulley. A single fixed pulley. This is a block. This one works like the axle. That's the pivot. I say it works as first class of lever. That is a single fixed pulley. This wheel, it is fixed on this block. This is our load. I can say this load is 50 kilograms of force. Then this is the effort. This is the effort. Then this is the block. Then this is the pivot. They are going to draw for you this type of pulley system, and they are going to ask you that which type of pulley system is shown in the diagram. This is a single fixed pulley. If you are asked to give a reason to support your answer, you will say the ring is fixed on the block, or the pulley, or the pulley is fixed on the block. That's why it is a single fixed pulley. Now I've said that it works as a first class of levers. Now when you look at it, you see this is the load and this is the effort. And where do we find the pivot? The pivot is between the load and the effort. That's why we say it works as first class of levers. And the advantage of using this single fixed pulley, it changes the direction of the effort. Instead of holding here and lift the load direct from the ground, this rope is going to help you, this pulley is going to help you. You are going to pull the rope going downwards. It is easier to lift going downwards than lifting going upwards. Because if you lift going upwards, you are going to use more effort, or you are going to use a lot of energy. And it's better you lift going downwards like that. Then we say that it has mechanical advantage of one. I remember, let us see. Now I've said, with the single fixed pulley, the effort needed to overcome the load has to be equal to the weight of the load. If the weight is 50 kilograms, if the load is 50 kilograms of force, even the effort has to be 50. I'm saying, if the load is 50 kilograms of force, this, to overcome this load, it needs you to be with the effort of 50 kilograms of force. If it is 50 kilograms of force, Your effort also supposed to be 50 kilograms of force to overcome this load. If it is less than, you will not be able to overcome this load. Now, if you are given this type of pulley, like the way you see it, and they ask you that which type of pulley is shown in the diagram, one single fixed pulley, what is the effort needed to overcome this load? Automatically, this effort has to be 50 kilograms of force because it has a mechanical advantage of one. Now let us see how we can find the mechanical advantage of a single fixed pulley. I remember telling you that mechanical advantage is the number of times a machine simplifies work. And I told you that if the mechanical advantage of a machine is less than one, it means that machine is useless to you, because you are going to use a lot of energy. Mechanical advantage has to be one and above. Then there you will say that this machine is helping me. Now this one has a mechanical advantage of one, but one to prove, how do we get that one? Example one. One to see, why do we say that it has a mechanical advantage of one? We say, find the mechanical advantage of, find the mechanical advantage, find the mechanical advantage of a pulley. Find the mechanical advantage of a pulley below. One to say, we have said that a single fixed pulley has a mechanical advantage of one. Now let us see if we can get that mechanical advantage of one. The first example. We say, find the mechanical advantage of a pulley below. That's a block. Now, if you are given a pulley system of that type and they ask you, you know, when they give you a pulley of this system, of this type, the first question, the question is that we always ask you to first identify the simple machine, you identify the type of pulley. If you are able to identify the type of pulley, to me, it means at least you are going to get the question is the answers correctly. Now we say that a single fixed pulley has a mechanical advantage of one. Now you are given the first example, which says, calculate the mechanical advantage or find the mechanical advantage of a pulley below. It has effort. This capital E represents effort. I talked about that one the time I talked about levers. This capital N stands represents Newton. The effort needed. I told you effort is given in newtons. Now they say find a mechanical advantage over Politburo. I remember we said that mechanical advantage is equal to load divided by effort. This capital M and capital A represent mechanical advantage. Then we say mechanical advantage is equal to load. Our load is 40 newtons divided by our effort, which is 40 newtons. Then we divide. This A goes with this one, 40 goes like that. Here we remain with 1 by 40, once by 40, once. Then we say our mechanical advantage is equal to 1. I remember I told you that when we are finding mechanical advantage, we don't put units, because I say that mechanical advantage is a ratio of load to effort. There is no need of putting units. Now, this one has proved that the mechanical advantage of a single fixed pulley is 1. Let me give you the last example, then I leave single fixed pulley. Now you ask me that what if they give you here, they put 80 here, then here they put 70. It's impossible. If it is a single fixed pulley, the energy or the effort to overcome the load, or the effort and the load are supposed to be equal, or the weight of the effort and the weight of the load are supposed to be equal. If here is 40, even the effort has to be 40. Now, another one, calculate, that's the second example two, calculate the mechanical advantage. Calculate the mechanical advantage calculate the mechanical advantage calculate the mechanical advantage calculate the mechanical advantage of a pulley below. I'm not going to calculate this one. I'm going to leave it for you. When you, after watching this video, you try to find the mechanical advantage of this pulley system. I know you'll get your answer as 1. Good enough, I've given the first example. Then this one is going to be your trial number, and see if you have understood. newtons, then the effort is also 100 newtons. Now you ask me that why am I using newtons? I can use kilograms of force, or I can use newtons. Now you are going to use that one as your trial number to calculate the mechanical advantage. Let me stop here for today. We shall meet again. Thank you.